It has surface. Surface. Many strings are fixed. They are fixed stiffly. Many strings. I think it may be around 5 or 6 strings are fixed on the rod. And all these strings are in different thickness. They are not same in nature. That the strings are having different diameter or thickness. They are all arranged in sequence. On one end, the thickest string. On the other end, thinnest string. When we pluck all these strings separately, then also we get the different kind of sound. So, even in this instrument, in the same instrument, the sound produced is different. It is because of different kind of strings are fixed. They are fixed at both the ends. When they are plucked, the sound produced is different. And you can observe the loudness of sound is more in the thickest string. Loudness of the sound is more in the thickest string. And from the thinnest string, the sound is more sharper. Means it produces more pinching effect when we pluck the thinnest string. So in this way, the sound is produced by all the instruments, and all the instruments are producing different kind of sound. So these are only the examples for the musical instruments, different kind of musical instruments. Now we move on to the next part, that as I already said, the sound is produced due to vibration of particles, vibration of material, vibration of the object in that material. Here in guitar, the string is vibrating. Like this, the vibrating parts are different. Now we have to discuss more about this vibration. The vibration or oscillation. We must know that oscillation or vibration. This term, as already discussed in the class 7th, here also we are going to discuss some more things about the oscillations. For this, once again, I take that same example as we were discussing in class 7, that is simple pendulum. Here we have the simple pendulum. This is the fixed support, rigid support. From this, a string, the string is weightless and inextensible. The other end is fitted with a spherical bob. This we call the bob. It is the bob. When there is no disturbance, the bob remains in its original position, that we call it is the mean position. It is mean position. When it is disturbed slightly, then the bob definitely shifted from its mean position and go to any of the sides. Suppose the bob goes in this path, along this path, to the new position, it goes to this new position, and that is known as extreme position. It is extreme position. At the extreme position, it cannot be at come to rest. It cannot come to rest. Again, it come back. It is because of unstableness produced in this position. It come back to the same position, that is mean position. From the mean position, it goes to extreme. Then from extreme, it come back to mean position. At the mean position, again, it won't come to rest immediately. So it moves to other side, opposite extreme. Here, it goes to opposite extreme. This is one of the extreme. Again, in the extreme position, it cannot be come to rest. Now it goes once again to the mean position. In this way, this bob moves to and fro. So the bob is moving to and fro. So it is oscillating. So it is in oscillatory motion, or it is in vibratory motion. Okay. These things were discussed in the last class also. Now, related to the oscillatory motion, some terms should also be discussed. Now, when do we say the bob has completed its one oscillation? That one oscillation means, the bob completed its one oscillation means, the motion of bob in which it moves from mean position to one extreme, then come back to opposite extreme, and come to the finally reach the mean position, then it has completed its one oscillation. This one oscillation can also be measured in the other way. It can also be measured from the extreme position also, from one extreme to opposite extreme, then coming back to the same extreme. That is also equal to one oscillation. So one oscillation can be measured in two methods. Mean position to one extreme, then to opposite extreme, finally coming to mean position. Now it has completed one oscillation. Otherwise, it may also be measured from the extreme position, from one extreme to opposite extreme, then going back to the same extreme. Now also it has completed its one oscillation. Right. This is one oscillation. Obviously, when it is moving to and fro, when it is moving from this mean position to opposite extreme, then coming back to mean position, definitely it takes some time. Definitely it takes time. It is not possible to complete that one oscillation instantly. At least some time will be taken. That time taken to complete one oscillation is known as time period. It is known as time period. Time period, it is represented by the symbol capital letter T. It should be capital letter T. Time period, because it is a fixed one. So time period, it is the total time taken by the particle. Though we are using the pendulum, it is not only for the pendulum. It is applicable for all the oscillating particles, all the vibrating particles. That whenever any particle is oscillating, in that the time taken by that particle, by that object to complete one oscillation is known as time period. Right? And one more thing should also be observed here. From the mean position to one extreme it goes. From the mean position to one extreme it goes. Suppose that time taken from mean to one extreme, that time taken is 1 second. Then from extreme to mean position also it takes the same time. From the mean to opposite extreme also same time is taken. Then coming back to mean position also same time. So it moves symmetrically. It moves symmetrically. The equal time is taken by the particle from mean to extreme, extreme to mean, then mean to extreme, again extreme to mean. And it is practically, it is not possible, but theoretically, we we are assuming, considering that it is taking equal time. Suppose it is taking 1 second to move from mean to extreme position. Obviously, the time period is 4 seconds. It is taking time 1 second from mean to extreme. Obviously, the total time, that is time period, definitely be 4 seconds. That is the time period. Okay. And one more term is, on disturbing this bob from the mean position, the bob is disturbed slightly, it moves to one side, it moves to extreme. The maximum displacement, whatever be the displacement produced in this bob from mean position to extreme position, that is known as amplitude. This is known as amplitude. So amplitude is the maximum displacement of the vibrating particle from mean position to extreme position. This is the maximum displacement. This is the amplitude. This amplitude of every vibrating particle is different. Time period for every vibrating particle is different. It is different. Okay. I think if you could remember, these terms were discussed in last year also. These terms. Now here, we are going to introduce one more term.